Hey guys, today was a pretty big update for Destiny 2. There's a lot of new changes to go over, but what I'm going to do in this video is highlight the most important ones and the most exciting ones that you should know. For the entire list of things in this update, check the description for the link to Bungie's patch notes, and you can read about everything there. For starters, we've got some big changes made to Xur. His faded engram can now drop Forsaken exotics, which if you don't already know how that works, it grants you one exotic per account every week that you don't already own. Interestingly enough, you can actually now get Wavesplitter, the previously PS4 exclusive trace rifle. I hopped over to Xur a minute before reset and was able to snag this out of the faded engram, which is good news for us Xbox and PC owners. Usually these PS4 exclusive items are locked for a year before coming to other platforms, but it's only been about 7 months, so this is a pretty big sign that the exclusivity deals with PlayStation have come to an end. Xur's inventory can now also offer randomly rolled perks, which is a welcome change and will definitely make Xur a little bit more useful in the coming weeks. Another big addition with this update was the introduction of 4 new catalysts: the Rat King exotic sidearm, the Prospector exotic grenade launcher, and the Hardlight exotic auto rifle all have catalysts that can be obtained through running strikes and nightfalls, while the Suros Regime exotic auto rifle has its catalyst tied to Crucible wins. The catalyst is a random drop at the end of those activities, so you just gotta play until you get them. The rewards in Destiny 2 got a big update this week. We have a lot of numbers as well, which is really helpful and totally unlike Bungie to actually give us real drop rate information. First off, the Dreaming City cosmetics got adjusted. The Dreaming City ship was bumped from 2% up to 20%. The Dreaming City ghost shell was bumped also up to 20%. And the Dreaming City sparrow was bumped from 5% to 20%. Arguably what it should have been all along, but here we are. Luckily, I was able to get the ghost to drop on my third run today, allowing me to finally be able to be Cursebreaker despite having everything but the ghost since November. This drop rate was a huge increase. So if you're missing the cosmetics, you will absolutely get them now, it is just a matter of time. Items in the Last Wish raid also saw a significant increase. The drop rate of 1,000 voices was doubled from 5% to 10%. The glittering key was bumped from 5% to 20%, and the Wishmaker shell saw its drop rate increased from 2% to 20%. And the Last Wish sparrow was also bumped up to 20%. Same thing as the Dreaming City stuff, those are going to be a lot easier to get now. Lore books is also another thing that got updated. If you open Cade's treasure map chest, found within the Ace in the Hole mission, it is a guaranteed drop for Cade's lore now, up from 40%. If you open any planetary chest, you'll now have a 50% chance of getting Cade lore, up from 4%. The Dreaming City lore book now has a 50% drop rate from public events, a 50% chance to drop from Blind Well tiers 1 through 3, and it is now guaranteed to drop from Lost Sectors and Ascendant Challenges. So do both of those if you still need to collect the Dreaming City lore. When it comes to the Tangled Shore lore books, you have a 50% chance of getting them from public events, heroic adventures, and Lost Sectors, so it's going to be much easier to get those as well. Ada 1 now sells all her weapon frames each week. There is no more rotation. But choose wisely, because once you complete 2 of the frames, the remaining ones are removed until the weekly reset. So basically, you get to pick the 2 you want to see for that week, which is really nice. Some changes that were not mentioned in the patch notes are: you can now preview ghost projections on your ghost while in your inventory, no longer having to equip it and then pop out of your inventory to see what it looks like. It's a small change, but it's really helpful. And something that isn't a small change, though, is now we have the ability to see what an armor piece or ornament looks like on a different class. If you're on a hunter, for example, you can now see what a Titan or a Warlock's exotic would look like. It's a bit jarring at first when you see the Spaceman or Spacewoman model, but I am so happy this change made it in. I've wanted this ability for so long. It's definitely a hugely appreciated quality of life change. Now on to Reckoning and Gambit Prime. Reckoning tier 2 and 3 boss kills now have a chance to drop a Gambit Prime weapon, and now the chances for a weapon drop increase each time a boss is killed without a drop. This drop protection system also applies to Gambit Prime, so every time you complete a match of Prime and don't get a weapon, your chances increase for the next match. Some other useful Gambit Prime changes include: the Invasion kills now heal 8% instead of 12% of a Primeval's health, and the Invasion Portal cooldown time has been increased to 40 seconds, up from 30. Also, the Drifter's weekly helmet bounties now all reward powerful gear, so that's 4 sources of powerful helmets, right there, per character, per week. When it comes to regular Gambit, the Protect the Runner Triumph now requires less motes banked. I believe it's only 75 now instead of 100, so much more obtainable, especially if you're a solo player playing with randoms. And the required blockers for the Taken Herder, Shepherd, and Whisperer Triumphs have now been reduced. They didn't give exact numbers on that, but I assume it's going to be much easier as well. And some other big changes to note that I'll quickly go through here are: Wardcliff Coil saw a 25% damage reduction in PvE against bosses and vehicles, sadly. I guess Bungie thought they went a little crazy with Wardcliff, and I do agree to an extent. The Titan Exotic Gauntlet Stronghold will no longer drain heavy ammo while guarding with Black Talon. Very nice change. The Warlock Exotic Gauntlet's Getaway Artist now correctly spawns a supercharged Arc Soul with the Storm Grenades. Vestian Dynasty was removed from the general loot pool and replaced with Arsenic Bite that can now have random rolls. I've gotten way too many of those Vestian Dynasties, so this was actually a nice change. The Gunsmith packages now will only reward Gunsmith weapons, so if you're hunting for a specific item in his loot pool, you now have a better chance of getting it. The Braytech RWP MK2 can now be infused above 600 power. The Mars Ghost Shell, the Polestar 2, saw its drop rate increased from 1% to 4%. You can now adjust your power handicap on the Nightfall scoring cards by 25 levels now, thank God. You can now reacquire both the Wizened Rebuke, Iron Banner Fusion, and the Recluse from the collections. And finally, a bunch of subclasses were buffed. A lot of abilities got improved, mainly from the Arc subclasses, but Nova Warp also saw a buff, while Dawnblade's bottom tree got a slight nerf so that it couldn't last forever. Bungie said they're also working on buffing Thundercrash and Top Tree Sentinel, and they're also playtesting Spectral Blades right now to make sure that gets tuned in the near future. Also, they did say they were working on fixing the Gambit Prime Sentry gear right now because of the exploit that was found with it, so the perks on it have been disabled for now. Just keep in mind if you are a Sentry player. There are a bunch of other smaller fixes for triumphs, bugs, and all sorts of stuff, so if you have any questions about something that wasn't answered here, definitely go read the patch notes. The link is in the description, because it was likely addressed in there. That's all you need to know for this week in Destiny, and thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.